On April 10th, 2015, the NOAA ship Okeanos Explorer was working about 40 kilometers off the coast of Puerto Rico. I was part of the shoreside science team, and I was working in the Exploration Command Center at NOAA headquarters. And through satellite telepresence, we're able to be connected to our ships at sea in near real time. We had the ROV Deep Discoverer diving at about 4,000 meters on Arecibo Amphitheater, which is a canyon not far from the Puerto Rico Trench. Deep Discoverer is a remotely operated vehicle. It's unmanned and it's tethered to the ship. It has a fantastic high definition camera system, so it brings back some stunning imagery. The vehicle was making a move up a slope. It was rocky. We came upon this gelatinous animal just above the seafloor. It looked very different. Tinafores are comb jellies. They have these rows of cilia combs. And when they pulsate, the light refracts back and it's a prism kind of light effect. And so when you see that, it's your instant clue that this is a tinafore. It was unlike tinafores I've seen before.
Let me get a little closer.
We were lucky on the dive. We actually got to see three different animals in three separate occasions. And on that second observation, we got a fantastic zoom on the high def. We saw lots of detail. After the dive that day, one of the first people I contacted was my friend and colleague, Alan Collins. Alan is an expert in jellyfish.
When I thought this thing, I just thought, that is so weird looking. It's like a party balloon, only instead of sort of having one string hanging down, it's got two little dangly bits, and on each of those dangly bits is a tentacle. I've never seen a tinafore like that before. I thought that there was at least a possibility that it was a new species.
Pilot, can we turn on the lasers?
Our ROV camera has lasers that provide a scale for us to be able to measure things in the deep ocean. As we saw that the animal itself was about 6 centimeters tall, but its tentacles were very long, 30 centimeters long. So the animal had this kind of bulbous body at the top and then very long trailing tentacles.
5 meters left, yeah.
We were lucky to have essentially a discovery within a discovery. In one of the video clips, we got to see some behavior. And those images and sequences of behavior are very exciting. Typically, new species are described by taking samples, taking animals back up into the lab, and doing a lot of laboratory analysis, both on the microscope and with genetic tissue.
Back when this was seen in 2015, the ROV Deep Discoverer wasn't equipped to do any sampling, so we had to rely solely on the high-definition video.
The process of describing a new genus and a new species takes a long time. In our case, it took 5 years. We were re-examining the video, and then we spent a lot of time communicating with other scientists on what we had found. And then it was doing the research, going through all of the literature. In the end, we described a new genus and a new species inside tinafores.
What I hope is that it will be discovered again and it will be sampled, so that we can get access to the information that's in the genome.
If they do and take a sample, it would unlock an enormous amount of additional information.
There are about 250,000 species known in the sea. There are numbers of species that have been seen only a handful of times. It is possible that it could be years, decades, maybe even a century before this species is encountered again. It's one of the things that makes the whole Okeanos Explorer operation so wonderful. You never know what you're gonna see. And often when you see something, it's never been seen before.
Anytime we encounter something new, anytime we encounter something exciting like this discovery, we add to the understanding people have about the ocean.
Good copy, 30 meters, bearing 250